About how loud the music is and whether or not they can make out the words. Now, so far, do you think it's too loud or what? How many say it's too loud? How many say it's not loud enough? All right, stand by the power racks. Crank it up. Let me take my jacket off.
Thank you. Shortly thereafter, God made the poodle. Now, as you might remember from your childhood, God was pretty good at making stuff a long time ago. His quality and his workmanship has gone down quite a bit. The Japanese have taken over where he left off. But when he originally constructed the poodle, it was a pretty sharp-looking dog. It had hair evenly distributed all over its charming, small, compact, canine-type body. It looked good to me. How about you? Then God made two big mistakes. The first one was called Man, and the second one was called Woo-Man. Woo-Man looked upon the poodle and said to herself, "Boy, I'd really like to fuck that dog, except for the fact that it's not mod enough for me." And so she turned to the man and said, "Sucker, go get a job." Whereupon the man trotted out immediately from the Garden of Eden and got a job and brought his paycheck home to the Woo Man, who took the money away from him and went out and bought a pair of scissors. And she took those scissors and clipped upon the poodle in these important areas: the snout, the thorax, the medulla, the managua, and the garmish right here. And then she put the dog in a position that might be favorable to her impending erotic procedures. She set the dog up like this. Up in the air like this, and looked deep into the eyes of the aforementioned poodle and said,
Oh, get it. Oh. music to my dog.
Alright, the poodle is biting it, the poodle is chewing it, and so is my equipment. Anyway, the name of this song is Filthy Habits.
Yeah.
Thank you. smile. I just wish someone did.
Expedite him in any way, I'm sure he'd be eternally grateful. You're probably wondering why I'm standing here on this stage blowing my nose like this, but we're in the middle of a tour that has taken us all around the world. We started off in Hawaii and went to New Zealand, then through Australia, then up through Japan. And then the trouble started. We had a week off in Copenhagen. And this little white piece of paper is the remnants of our vacation in Copenhagen. And I'm going to make these available at no additional charge after the show. I'll just pile them up right here. If anybody wants them, can help themselves. A little piece of Danish humor right here on stage. The name of this song... name of this song, dear folks, because this is really a sensitive ballad kind of a song. This is called Black Napkins.
Thank you. me she loved me, I believe what she saw, yeah, yeah, yeah. Kill me for a song of war. Thank you. Italian Bobby was a friend of mine. Open three of his eyes and the boots damn black. Open four of his eyes and the boots damn black. Open five of his eyes and the boots damn black. And open six of his eyes and the boots damn black. But Frank, you know, she might be a devil. You know they call her Copenhagen for short, but boom, boom. You see it on top. Might be a devil. Little bit of red dress on, somebody says, don't snow over here. Rain in the snow. Just might be a little tail right here. Do is come up and say hi. Half an hour later, she had French kiss cry. And then, Bobby said goodnight.
He was a playboy type, he smoked a pipe. His favorite phrase was out of sight. He had an Irish hair. It was a singles bar on Tuesday night. The moon was dim, the band was tight. They did the pop together. What a splendid sight. Their teeth were white. The drinks were cheap. It was ladies' night.
Was glad that he met her.
She was an office girl. Her favorite group was.
They discussed the weather.
Under her, maybe that's what I'm in like. I'm under her, maybe that's what I'm in like. Oh, baby, don't you want it? Baby, don't you want it? Baby, don't you want it?
She was a lonely sort, a little too short. Her jokes were dumb, and her favorite sport was hockey in the winter.
Shut up! Watch out! Watch out!
He was duly impressed and was quick to suggest that he sport with a puck. Had to be about the best as he jabbed his elbow in her.
Later on, they went off to where the music was soft. The candles were tripping. They saw a real hippie. The lights just brown, and soon they found that the crowd around had a jammed room. But it seemed to be getting better.
Baby, don't you want a man like? Baby, don't you want? Baby, don't you want? Baby, don't you want?
He took her home to a motor court. Oh, she wouldn't kiss him. He tried to ignore it, but it made him angry. Called her a slut, a pig, and a whore, a bitch, and a cunt, and she slammed the door in a petulant frenzy.
Dead.
So he has to use the phone,
and she gives him
some hair.
Baby, don't you want a man like that? Baby, don't you want a man like that? Baby, don't you want a man? Baby, don't you want a man? Baby, don't you want a man sometimes?
All right, now, ladies and gentlemen, one more minute here. Listen, this is the true story. This is the true story of Michael Kenyon, the Illinois Enema Bandit. Now, some of you, especially in the armed services, might have known Michael earlier on in his career. For the past 10 years, Michael has been ravaging the central part of the United States of America, committing a series of horrible crimes directed against the college-educated women in the area just outside of Chicago. Michael would put on a ski mask and break into the homes of the college-educated women and at gunpoint force them to submit to a cosmically oriented internal rinse job. In other words, that's right, he'd give them the giant, enormous teenage Kleister spritzing of their dreams. Michael had this briefcase, and in the briefcase was the gun, the rope, the thermometer, and the enema bag. He would tie the girls up. Then he would pull out the thermometer and stick it up their blowhole. And then he'd pull it out and look at it and whiff it and stick it back in. He'd take the bag, and he'd dash over to the toilet with the bag. Buddy, and then he'd take the nozzle on the bag and whoop right up the butt again. And then he'd beat his meat. Hey, take it away, Michael, out of sight, out of sight, Michael. And then he would tell the girl not to call the police for at least 5 minutes after he was done, and he would run away. Well, they caught him in December 1975. Michael Kenyon, the Illinois Enema Bandit, was brought to justice on 5 counts of armed robbery, because apparently there is no law against giving a college-educated woman a Kleister spritzing. He made his big mistake when he robbed the ugly ones. And that's the way it goes. So any of you folks here in Houston that want to pump them up, remember, don't take their money, do it for free, and you'll have more fun. Here we go.
Just like water.
I'm
waiting
for you.
Judge will have him for a special guest. The DA will order a secret test. Stuff his pudgy little thumbs in the side of his vest. Then they'll put out a call, yo, for the jury moves, that's you. And the judge will say, no poo-poo jokes. That's right. No dragging the bandit. Policy saying, don't know Betty, don't know hell, no sympathy. Hot soapy water in the first degree, and the bandit might say, why is it hit you hard? It must be just what they all need. It must be what they all need. I'm scared to pick up that guitar. It's probably out of tune by now. Stay tuned for this song, ladies and gentlemen. It must be just what they all need in a man.
Let me see your thumb. 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 In the room where the giant fire purple works. torture never stopped. The torture never stopped. The torture never stopped. The torture never stopped. Slime and rot, rats and snot, vomit on the floor. 50 ugly soldiers, man, holding spears by the iron door. Knives and spikes and guns and the likes of every tool of pain. And a sinister spherical with a bucket and a mop where the blood goes down the drain.
And it stinks so bad, the stone's been choking.
We've been through this drought.
In the room where the giant fire felt the worst.
And the torture never stops. Torture never stops. Torture. In his dungeon of despair. An evil prince eats a steaming schwein in a chamber right near there. He eats the snouts and the trotters first. Yup, yup. The loins and the groins is soon dispersed. His carving style is well rehearsed. Stands and shouts. All men be cursed. All men be cursed. All men be cursed. All men be cursed. And you think anybody would disagree with that son of a bitch? No, no, no one durst. He's the best, of course, of all the world.
He's the best, of course, of all the world.
Some wrong been done, he done it first.
Some wrong been done, he done it first. And it stinks so bad, the stone's been choking.
We've been greenish drops.
In the room where the iron's naked.
Where the torture never stops. Torture never stops. The torture never stops. The torture never stops.
Thank you. this ain't it.
Been explained since at first it was created, but a dungeon like a sin,
that's a nice one,
requires not much locking in of everything that's ever been. I can enjoy that really a lot after a week in Copenhagen. Bring that sucker back over here. Anything, come on. I like this side too. Listen. No, really get this side over here because we have to go back to Copenhagen. I want to make sure I'm prepared when I get back there. Thank you very much. That's going to help me out a lot tonight. Now, where was I? Oh, yeah.
Look at him.
Oh. Look at her.
Look at that. You got a full moon day with
us. Come on over
here,
look at him.
That's what's the deal we're dealing in. That's what's the deal we're dealing in. That's what's the deal we're dealing in. That's what's the deal we're dealing in.
And now back to Copenhagen once again.
Thank you.
No, no, no.
Thank you. Halfway there, cause if my mind's tore up, my body don't care. I love my chinny chin chin and says, my, 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 what sort of thing might this lady get high upon? You know, the $40 bill didn't matter no more. But her sister got naked and laid on the floor. She said, Dynamo might win the bet, but she could use a little if I wasn't done yet. But just because the sun had no place in the sky, no reason to assume I wouldn't give her a try. So I pulled on her hair, got her legs in the air, and asked if she had any cooties in there.
No.
Danke, danke, danke. All right, here comes one of those songs.
Yeah.